In this video, I want to talk about how to progress your workouts across your training plan. Now, one of the things that I have observed is that experienced and successful runners, they execute their training plan slightly different than inexperienced runners. Experienced runners know that they need to be patient in the training process. They know they will be fitter later in their training plan. They know that they're building toward peak fitness on race day, so they're not quite as in a hurry as inexperienced runners are early in their training plans. They know I will be fitter later. These workouts just build toward the future. As a result, they progress through their workouts in kind of an interesting way. And this is what I really taught a lot of the pro athletes that I worked with. And I think it works with all athletes. I certainly do it myself. So early in your training plan, when you're first starting to do your race-specific workouts, you are more conservative. Experienced runners are more conservative in those early workouts. They hold back a little bit and they just focus on get the workout in, typically just trying to get at least the minimum, but often the maximum training load out of that, leaving themselves feeling like, I could have gone faster. I could have done a little bit more. You'll hear them say that a lot. I held back a little bit. I could have done another repeat or another mile at that same pace. They're just more conservative early in their training, their work. They're just more conservative in their workouts earlier in their training plan. Now, once they get to the middle part of their race-specific training, then you see that they hold themselves back slightly. They're more controlled early in the workouts compared to inexperienced runners. But then they begin to push themselves in the second half of the workouts. Kind of that go-zone mentality. They are already practicing it in training. They get through the first half sort of under control, and then they begin to really challenge themselves in the second half. It kind of fits into that last set, best set, last set, rep, best rep, last mile, best mile, that sort of mentality that you've probably heard me talk about in other videos. So in the middle of their training plan, they are starting to still control themselves early, so they're not going out too fast, but they begin to really challenge themselves later, kind of challenging their fitness to get a great adaptation from those workouts. Now, the third phase of the training for them, when they get into the later stages of their training plan, their key race is coming soon. Then they have the mentality that they try to run as easily as possible to hit their goal paces through the bulk of the workout. And maybe only in the last, say, 25% of the workout do they kind of let loose and kind of challenge themselves. What they know is, I'm already coming to a peak. I don't need to beat this workout. I don't need to beat the training paces. I need to be more controlled so I don't burn myself out in training. You'll hear them say, don't leave the race in training. I don't want to do too much right now. I'm saving my fitness for a peak on race day. That is a great way to execute your workouts, particularly in the later stages of your training plan. Inexperienced runners often are trying to beat their workouts. They push as hard as they can. They feel like, oh, I'm fit. I can beat these workouts. I can run faster times than I ever have. So they really push to achieve those times, sometimes because they maybe are not confident they're going to be able to run their goal pace. So they need that workout result. But this is kind of the opposite of what the experienced runners do, whereas they start to kind of hold themselves back a little bit. How easily can I run within the pace range? Slightly different mentality, but what it does is it leaves them fresh for their peak race. So that's why you see these experienced runners, they kind of always have really good races because they controlled themselves early in the training, got in the work. Then they begin to challenge themselves in the middle of their training cycle to push their fitness higher. And then they control themselves as the race gets close so they don't leave the race in training. So I wanted to put this quick video together just to sort of talk about that, the way that experienced runners progress themselves in workouts. It's certainly what I do. I just started a hill plan, and so today was my first hill set of hill workouts. All I cared about was, do the volume, get in the repetitions, hold yourself back, know that you can finish the workout. You could have done one or two more hill repeats at the same effort, because I know in about a month I'll be ready to attack those hills as I get into the kind of middle part of this training phase. So follow that pattern. What it does is it results in more better runs. So more frequently you will have better workouts because you're not going out too fast early in the workouts. You're really getting the great stimulus that your body wants. You get greater volume in those workouts because you don't go too fast too early. So you tend to do the higher end of the volume range, which of course gives you more training stimulus. And then you can peak at your race. And that is one of the things that experienced runners do. You see them, their fitness builds up to this peak. They have less erratic training and they seem to always be prepared for their race. So just a quick video, start to think about this as you march through your early part of your race specific training, the middle part, and then the later part, how mentally you can control yourself and kind of execute in the way that the experienced runners do. And I bet you'll have a better training cycle and then a better result in your peak race. As always, if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I'll talk to you again real soon.